On behalf of our director, Dr. Nippon Chinanwet, I will present the title that the status and preparation of Thailand toward containment of drug resistance and elimination. So first part, I will present the status. And the second, I will present that the story that about the containment and the way to go to elimination in Thailand. So just a brief for the API of malaria for last 10 years, the API is quite really low and not different. It's quite stable. So if I look at this graph, maybe I'm happy that malaria in Thailand is quite really low and maybe nothing to do. But if you look at the number of cases, again, you can see that there are still some of the cases. In 2013, we have around 20,000 of Thai M1, and also we have M2 also. M1 is mean migrant or the foreign worker that live in Thailand more than 6 months, and M2 is foreign workers or migrants that live in Thailand less than 6 months. So M2 is quite a more movement population. So among total of cases, we also have the case in M2 also. How about the species? Now the predominant is vivax overall in Thailand, but if you like look at in some area, you found that in some area may still have a PF more than a PV, but overall for the country, the proportion of PV is more than PF. And I would like to orientation about the area stratification that we use for quite long term, maybe more than 60 years, that we classified in Thailand for transmission area and non-transmission area. And for transmission area, we also subclassify as high transmission, that is A1. And we use the criteria that have a cases more than 6 months per year. And for the low transmission, is they have a cases less than 6 months per year. And for non-transmission area, we classify as B1 and B2. So B1 is non-transmission but have vector, and B2 is no transmission and no vector. So maybe Thailand have done activity for many years, and this activity is like going into the elimination already. So it's very possible to going to the elimination in Thailand. And look at the village, the unit in village, comparing 2012 and 2013 according to the area classification. You can see that in 2013, in some area in northeast of Thailand, Sakonakhon and Kalasin, they have some of the village that have cases. Previously, they no have. And in the south of Thailand also, deep south Thailand, that previously no indigenous cases, but in 2013, there are some of the indigenous cases. So even this area is classified as B1 or B2, but if we don't have a mechanism to maintain, to investigate the cases, maybe it can occur the outbreak. And if you classify the area by the tier, you can see that in the area, in some province that we have border with Myanmar, for example, Tak province, or Kanchanaburi province or Ranong province, they classify as tier one. So it has an evidence of drug resistance in this area. And how about the population at risk at the tier one, tier two, and tier three? It's around 1,500,000 among our total population. That is 65 million. And among of this, of population in risk area, some of them live in the tier one area. So I would like to matching or to try to show you again that as I already present that in Thailand we classify the area as A1, A2, B1 and B2. So again, for the elimination, B1 and B2 is most likely is going to elimination or already going to elimination. But yes, again, that we will have some mechanism to show that, for example, we have foci investigation or not in that area to guarantee that it's maybe going in the elimination. And about the data or information about the efficacy, we also done the activity that called TES, therapeutic efficacy study. And this map, I show the data that we have from 2008, and maybe we show the data until 2012. And you can see that in 2009, we have a problem in Trat province that have border with Cambodia. And the efficacy of artesunate metformin it's decreased 73%. And with this point, it will come with the containment project in Thailand that started in 2009 that I will present the activity of at that time. In 2010 and 2011, 2012, again, you can see that in Kanchanaburi province that have a border with Myanmar in the west of Thailand. Previously, in 2009, Kanchanaburi province still have quite well effect, for effectiveness of artesunate metformin, 92.7%. But in 2012, the efficacy is go down to 72.4%. So again, this area will be focusing and consider about the drug regimen that used in this area. So all of information that I present, the challenges, or maybe we call that the bottlenecks or constraint, it's again drug resistant in Thailand. Also the people migrate to endemic area. Everyone know that in 2 or 3 years, next 2 or 3 years, we are going to the AEC. So the traveling or movement of population will be more and more increased. And in some area, we have a conflict area or unrest area, not include Bangkok, but in the deep south of Thailand. From that situation, we have some of malaria strategy that we will use during 2012 to 2020. We have six strategy. The first one is national malaria management. We are enhancing and we work with the community. So community participation will be encouraged. Not the public only, but also a private sector also that maybe get involved in malaria elimination program. And subnational elimination will be occur because now, you know, Thailand is going into decentralization and the budget manpower is going to the local administrative organization. So now, how can we move or collaborate with that organized and any other sector to make a sub-national elimination first. Strategy number three, how to collaborate with the risk population and the border area. As I present that, we have M2 that still have a cases, and we have border with our neighboring country, Myanmar and Cambodia, and movement of population is quite high. So how to catch up this population? Maybe we can establish that called border malaria post to give health service for the malaria detection and treatment, and collaborate with our neighboring country about the to eliminate the substandard drugs, anti-malaria drugs, and fake drugs. The number four is perform enhanced surveillance prevention and control of drug-resistant malaria parasite. So, continuous TS should be done. So now, in 2013, we also have the site of study of TS that along Thai-Myanmar border and also Thai-Cambodia border. Number five is promote human capacity building. That also very important, because when the staff of malaria don't use their skill, they will lose their skill. For example, the microscopist, if they do not examine the bacilli for a long time, they will cannot differentiate about the PF and PV. So how to refresh the skill again is also important. And number six, about the malaria research and development. And I think two days ago, we have some meeting that talk about the OR, or operational research, much. And it will be very important and useful, because result from OR research can use in for implement for the real situation. So six of the malaria strategy that we will cope with the situation, the problem that we will face on now. And how about the past? As I present that, in 2009, we have problem in Trat province. The efficacy of artesunate mefloquine is just 70%. And we have experience with this project, Malaria Containment Project, that's supported by Bill Melinda Gates Foundation for 2 years. And at that time, a lot of new things, innovation was occur. For example, to decrease drug pressure for selection of artemisinin-resistant malaria parasite, it is the first time, and I can claim that first time in the world, that we use amalalone or atovaquone proguanil to treat malaria, not for prophylaxis. And we also use dot techniques to make sure that the patient will have a full dose of the anti-malaria drug. We also have a system that called Malaria Information System, EMIS, that developed, collaborate with the Mahidol University by the BioFIC. And the purpose of EMIS is to make it effective for follow up the patient and for effective for the case investigation also. And at that time, BCC was applied for the objective or the purpose of the malaria containment at that time. So bilingual language of IEC was produced also. And some of the operational research, for example, use of malalone, efficacy of the malalone also evaluated also. And from that containment project, I would like to say that we use that concept to apply for a wider extent project that is partnership of containment of artemisinin-resistant and moving toward the elimination of plasmodium in Thailand. That is supported by Global Fund. Why is partnership? Because not only Department of Disease Control, not only Bureau of Vector-Borne Disease, but we also have BioFIC, we also have the institute like Kinan. We also have Malaria Consortium, IOM, ARC, or SMIU that will work together as a partnership to containment of the artemisinin and moving forward to elimination of plasmodium in Thailand. And as I said that, the concept applied from the containment project, so concept of ensuring effective treatment, diagnosis and treatment also apply. So artemisinin combination therapy is emphasis and monotherapy will be banned in Thailand. And also we also apply DOT for PF, but for PV we still don't use it, but we will consider that how can we cope with 14 days of primaquine, because it's quite a long. Some experts say that tuberculosis that will have 6 months for anti-tuberculosis can done DOT. Why just only 14 days of primaquine that treat YVAC cannot? So it's a challenge question and thinking of our staff to how to increase the adherence or of a treatment of YVAC by use DOT or the technique that will be increased the full cost of primaquine to treat YVAC. Border malaria post is established to make more health facility more available of the people in outreach area, in border area to use the service. And also case active case detection should occur in many ways. So not only passive case that waiting for the patient come to see the doctor or staff at the malaria clinic or malaria post or hospital, but we are going to see the patient in the community also. And foresight investigation and the case investigation survey also done in this project to capture and to stop the spreading of the malaria cases. And about the vector control, mainly we use long-lasting insecticide net to be a major for the vector control. And we have a goal that one person will have one bed net. And for M2, just suspected, that means just have a fever, we also provide long-lasting insecticide treatment and free of charge. For spraying indoor residual spray, we use IIS of indoor residual spray for just to control or foresight IIS. So now the long-lasting insecticide is the main to implement for the vector control. And also we have a research project to mapping and look at the distribution of dynamic potential malaria vector along Thai-Myanmar border. Also look at the behavior of the vector of the mosquito, the bioenomic, bioassay also. We also have BCC and community mobilization and advocacy. And in this issue, the team of Bureau of Vector-Borne Disease with any other organization staff that try to find a key message and will be use that key message as a mass media. So just not only pamphlet or poster, we also use radio or song to be used to make a community to change the behavior. And also we use a volunteer, village health volunteer, community health worker, migrant health volunteer to help us to do the BCC activity also. And the coordination also very important. As I said that not only Thailand, we also have our neighboring countries. So how to coordinate with Myanmar and how to coordinate with the Cambodia. So in this project also have a collaboration activity with our neighboring country. And apart from this project, we also have the project that called Twin City with Myanmar, that we will have meeting together, change information of the malaria together. And we also use a web-based information system that start in the containment project and now is extended for many of the province that will use the web-based information system, and it's real-time. So it means that it's as fast as possible to reflect the investigation. But we also facing the problem that even we have quite well tools that is a web-based information system, but how can we encourage the local staff to use it to analyze the local information? Because if you have good tools but you don't use it, it's useless. So it will be encourage the local staff also to use this tool to make an investigation to analyze the situation in the local. So that is the activity, the objective under the global fund. But it's not enough, because recently we think about the regional and we view elimination of falciparum from greater Mekong sub-region. So not just only Thailand, but now the policy is quite extended. Not just only Thailand, we will think out of Thailand also. And also because of this, maybe a representative from Cambodia also represent that. It's emergency response to artemisinin resistance in greater Mekong sub-region. And last 2 days, we talked about the operational research for how to emergency respond. So emergency is mean that it's like when a patient have a trauma, we will resuscitate him immediately, something like that. So it's urgent to do something. So with that, we have regional artemisinin initiative and may come with this, some of this project. EFSAT for site screening and treatment will be with the new tool PCR or reactive case detection, more screen of asymptomatic patient with LAMP technique, something like that. And also some study of the outdoor transmission, use a cross that treat with insecticide and see that it can protect outdoor transmission or not, something like that. That may be occur. That may be fill the gap that already supported by a global fund, something like that. So if we can fill that, we hope that we have a target that in 2016, the API or mobility will go down to 0.2. That I think is possible. And mobility, mortality also decline. In 2016, we hope that 0.05 per 100,000. And also the area that is no transmission, 60% of the area in Thailand, 60% will be have no transmission in 2016, and maybe 80% in 2020. And hopefully that if we can done very well, maybe full elimination in Thailand before 2020 or in 2020, that will be achieve the goal of our strategy. So thank you very much.